Hello everyone, welcome back. So today I wanted to share with you how I refill my nail extensions. So I will be showing you how I file them and apply the product and then again shape them to make them look like extremely new. So let's begin with the process. So the very first step that I do is file down the product that is lifting and that has grown out. So you can see that there is a little bit of product which has lifted on both of these nails. So I will be just filing down the excessive product so that I can clear off the surface and apply a new product. So when you file down the acrylic that is lifted, it is important that you do not rub your natural nail. You just have to file down the acrylic. So these are what my nails look like. You now cannot really see a difference between the acrylic and my natural nail. Of course, I know where the acrylic starts and ends, but you cannot see that line. So it is important to merge two of these together. So before applying the acrylic, I always apply a primer. You don't need to have a heavy hand with this, and also you just apply the primer on the natural nail and you need not apply it on the acrylic. So I just dab it in order to avoid the primer moving on to my cuticles and the skin. So yes, that is very important. Now let's move on to the product application. For applying the product, I'm using a thick brush. It's a very dense and a big brush which you can buy from Amazon. So before applying the acrylic, I wet the natural nail and the surface where I have to apply with a little bit of monomer. This gives me a little bit of time to move the product, and also the acrylic does not dry faster in doing this. So that's a hack that you can take forward. So now I am moving the acrylic so that it gets into all the corners, avoiding the cuticle area. I always keep a little bit of gap between the cuticle and right from where the product is starting. So now I just flatten the acrylic so that it looks smooth. I know there are a little bit of bubbles that came in, so it's okay because I'm going to apply nail paint on this, so it's not gonna see. Otherwise, in case you plan to keep your nails just like that, then you have to make sure that there are no air bubbles. And also I missed a little bit of corners, so now I am applying the acrylic on the corners. So I went ahead and did the same thing for my ring finger so that I can go ahead and start with the filing process. So these are how my nails look like with the acrylic on, and now let's go ahead and file. So I use a combination of hand file and drill to remove the excess acrylic. In case you're new to the drill, please make sure to practice beforehand before you actually use it on your nails or on someone else. So I'll be filing them and I'll be back. So these are what my nails look like. Special attention is to be given to flatten the cuticle area. You have to make a very smooth transition from the natural nail to the acrylic extension that is there. Only then your extensions will look really perfect and natural. So the very last step that we are supposed to do is to put on the gel top coat. Gel top coat does not yellow your nails. Please avoid a regular top coat because that will not stay for long, and also capping the edges is very important. So once you have added generous amount of top coat, go ahead and cure your nails. So these are how my nails look like after all the process and after the gel top coat cured. I really hope that you guys find the video helpful. Please comment down in case you have any suggestions. Thank you so much.